a couple of good wins, but fair to say it's been a difficult season for them too.
They certainly haven't met the sky-high standards. And you look at that form line, not a great deal of green in there. Yes, the one win in recent times was that 7-0, but the international break, we were discussing, Grace, at just how much the momentum of the A-League season felt like it had been halted and now really kicking back into gear. I guess a Nestor Iran Kunda hat-trick on Friday night will do that to remind everyone that the A-League is back from an international break.
Oh, pretty perfect way to kick things off again for the weekend. Entertaining at Coopers as it always is. But for City, you're right, 18 days since they had that emphatic 7-0 result against the Wanderers. They would have liked perhaps a game a little sooner to continue that momentum, so it's an important fixture this afternoon.
And at this time of the season, you can see that the markings and the pitch is just a little bit more rugged, a little heavier. Super Rugby and the NRL making their return, and it is a ground that gets a lot of traffic when those winter codes return to play. So far, Melbourne City are making it look pretty slick. That pass out to the right flank for Manon Iakalish, not able to connect. No Lucas Moragas today for the Newcastle Jets, so the left-back corner will be a keen point of interest. Daniel Wilmering starts there. We know his versatility to push up the pitch, but being defensively accountable will be potentially a big challenge against Iakalish. Right now, Newcastle unable to advance with the ball. Steins gives possession away to Raish. And the little back-heeled flick is a clever one from Leo Natel. Togai Aslan wants to slow everything down. Bogarkovic trying to make space between the lines. Feeds it out to Iakalish. Now Callum Talbot. His pass definitely not to the advantage of Diego. Long ball. Looping eventually onto the head of Dayningham. He finds the safety of the line. The fringe New Zealand international, Dayningham. Aslan. Wonder how the Newcastle midfield will assign themselves to him. You saw Callum Timmins there was right on his case when he had possession, but now Aslan allowed to drift between the lines and wait in the pocket. Here's Diego. And now Fernandez. Melbourne City happy to be very patient. So, Grace, Newcastle did name two, you'd say, defensive midfielders or screening midfielders in Timmins and Grozos. Will they have a plan where one of them tags on and tags off, marking Togo Aslan?
Yeah, look, I think they'll have to, given the kind of delivery service we see from Aslan. Everything creatively comes through the middle. For him, such a talented player. And too interesting for me, seeing the adjustment in the Newcastle midfield. Brandon O'Neill, who has all but started every game bar two, not in the starting lineup today for the Jets. And that's a big move for Rob Stanton. Two, you mentioned Moragas unavailable today for Newcastle. That's a huge out in my eyes. What he provides in the way of an attacking outlet for the Jets has been excellent all season. That's a big loss.
Mark Natter here, one of the nominees for the Young Player of the Month during the course of the season. And Daniel Cook is immediately being called in to lay down the law for an early foul here.
Yeah, it's a clever little move there from Steins, knew the contact was coming.
Apologies, I called him a Western Australian. Daniel Cook is a proud South Australian, Grace. Well established in the South Australian NPL, but still building his reputation at the A-League level. Here's Clayton Taylor, and Stamatolopoulos gave himself up offside. Didn't play the ball, and so Jamie Young will get his first touch. Kostolos Stamatolopoulos linked with moves to the English Championship, to Serie B. His goal-scoring form. If he wins the Golden Boot, there'll be no shortage of suitors. It'll be up to the Jets to try and keep him. However, Ryan Scott has gone wandering out of his penalty area. Trouble here. And then the ball is knocked straight into his arms by Togo Aslan. And what a let-off for Ryan Scott returning to his hometown of Melbourne.
Well, nervy moments here for Ryan Scott. He's come well and truly off his line outside the box. And he is still holding the space instead of retreating. Perhaps a little fortunate for Scott that Togo Aslan couldn't clear him with that first kick.
Well, the way in which he found himself out in no man's land was alarming, but he was able to recover. Now Clayton Taylor is going to press here and just ask a question of the City defence. Wilmering is pushed all the way up. And a couple of flick volleys on allow Melbourne City to find their way up to the halfway line. Noise being made by the Melbourne City fans. Amy Park. It's a beautiful afternoon. Late March day and the weather. It's been a really summer-like March down in Melbourne with some of the hot days they've had. So nice to see perfect conditions for football this afternoon. The early tempo of the game perhaps reflecting that Talbot in against Piscopo. And the call is going Melbourne City's way. Garkovic up to the ball. Samuel Suprayen finds Leo Natel on the flank. The underlapping run is coming from Vicente Fernandez. Lances were further afield. Garkovic! Oh, he showed us his technique and he very nearly nestled it on the left.
It's a well-worked chance early on in this match for Melbourne City. Nice switch of play. The first time header back to Ugarkovic. Brings it down on one touch. Gets a strike away on the second. It's neatly done. It almost looked like he just hesitated a little on the shot and scooped it away. It has produced a couple of moments of magic across the season.
And now Newcastle, perhaps their first attack of note. Rino Piscopo to Daniel Steins. And the return ball. Young able to clear. After the slight challenge intervention, went with his feet Jamie Young and was able to stop the ball being really slide tackled into the net by Rino Piscopo.
A nice chance too from Newcastle. Good first time pass through from Steins. Clever from Jamie Young. He had to be thinking on his feet and was.
Jago headed down by Ingham. For handball, and the referee agrees. Costa Grozos, the man penalised. City quick to take the restart. Now Arslan, able to get around Grozos and drives a shot, which is easy pickings for Ryan Scott. Well, we were talking about the formation when we saw the Newcastle lineup pre-game, Grace. I mean, I'm not suggesting they've gone with a 4-2-2-2. It's still materialising in front of our eyes. We think there's width there, but interesting to see the layers of the midfield and the creativity in both Steins and Piscopo and exactly where they were going to take up position.
Yeah, I've just been watching the last couple of minutes to see exactly that, how the Newcastle formation shapes out. Although he's a little deeper for the moment, Piscopo, for large parts in those opening few minutes, was alongside Stamatolopoulos almost. Setting up in a 4-2-4 and those wide players having to do a lot of running to get back into shape. You see here it's Wilmering hugging the touchline, looking for that width.
Chanchar takes the game on. Steins just got goal side of Jago, but then had to wheel around and buy some time. Ingham sold the contact and the referee agrees, and you can see Dane Ingham's very unhappy about it. Daniel Steins into protest as well. The Jets are making the case there's been a couple of grabs like this already and Fernandez has been the culprit.
Well, Ingham not happy at all. Tidy little nutmegs to create some room for himself, but if nothing less, a good opportunity for the Jets to send some numbers into the box.
Interesting that Rino Piscopo, as soon as Daniel Cook drew that circle for where the free kick was to be taken, he scrubbed it out with his boot in the blink of an eye. Clearly didn't like the little patch of grass where this free kick's going to be taken from. Here's Grozos now. Grozos whips in the free kick and held onto by Jamie Young. So an enterprising first 10 minutes where City have slightly shaded it, but Newcastle have shown us that they are capable of building an attack.
Never really any doubt about that for Newcastle. I've spoken a lot about their first half performances across the course of the season. They can well and truly build an attack. It's more about their second half defensive work that has let them down on a few occasions. Bob Stanton has spoken a lot about it.
Attempted flick from Max Caputo. Exchange of headers, Wilmering. Clayton Taylor. And away goes City through the left. And Mattel, Fernandez gives him the overlapping run. And the first time cross, he's going to still tumble live in play. Fernandez goes to ground again, and have the Jets done enough to get themselves a goal kick? They have, but proving a bit of a tough customer to deal with.
A bit of an awkward one. Just spinning into play more than anything. A good forward movement by Fernandez. Offering that option.
City press very high at the moment. Putting pressure on the ball and Piscopo unable to keep possession. Subsequently, Yakalish, Jago. Back out to Talbot, first time ball. Aslan couldn't quite set his feet for a run at the ball. Jago ironed out. No free kick forthcoming. Yakalish. Talbot once more. Tests his left foot this time. And Caputo headed it straight at Ryan Scott. Either side of him, that may well have been 1-0.
That's such a good ball into the box there by Talbot. Delightful delivery, just evading the heads of all the Jets players. But Caputo, gifted on that occasion, just needed to redirect that either side of Ryan Scott. A perfect opportunity. That one's gone begging.
There's the action areas so far. You can see 10% more taking place in Newcastle's defence than that of Melbourne City. 19-year-old Max Caputo, the two A-League goals in his career and just the one this season, but one of them was against the Jets. Of course, he is preferred to Jamie McLaren, who remains on the bench. Talbot, early ball. Ugarkovic, the chaser, and held on to by Ryan Scott. Foul here. And again, Daniel Steins will be quick to protest that the foul count is starting to add up against Melbourne City. No thoughts of producing a card. Just a calm down chat on this occasion from the referee to Cook to Fernandez. Natta has to go back to his keeper, Ryan Scott. Faced with Caputo, who nearly deflected the ball goalbound. Lux of fortune, a couple of escapes for Ryan Scott in the first 15 minutes. City perhaps buoyed by the fact their press is starting to buy mistakes.
Yeah, nervy moments there for Ryan Scott. Just decision making on the ball on a couple of occasions has been poor. And as well, the run shaping up of Max Caputo was clever. Ryan Scott just needed to clear that one to relieve the pressure for a moment.
Ingham can relieve that pressure now for Newcastle. Steins. Timmins. The Jets happy to reset rather than attempt to rush a City defence that was largely back and set. And the cross from wide is going to sail out, a bit of a miss hit. And as the ball is out for a goal kick, just taking another look here at the rather awkward back pass here that Ryan Scott nearly got caught by Max Caputo. And his body opened up a little bit too much, if anything. City look to build again. Yakalish. Now Arslan. Nada blocks his progress. Talbot, a little faint. Can't get the better of Clayton Taylor. Natel. Sends Ingham sliding, but he's quick to recover his feet. Fernandez. And a good defensive header by Philip Chancha. Leo Natel, this time shut down by Steins. Stamatolopoulos back helping out the defence. And a clever little chip down the line. As the ball goes out for a throw, it gives us a chance to go down to the pitch side and say good afternoon to Michael Zappane.
Yeah, good afternoon, Tao and Grace. Fantastic. As you mentioned, Tao, this is the best time of year in Melbourne. Sunny conditions today. And the pitch, you mentioned there are markings on it, but it is in magnificent condition. How about that for a side? Perhaps something you wouldn't have thought you'd seen at the start of the season. Matt Leckie and Jamie McLaren both on the bench for Melbourne City this afternoon. Both for very different reasons, of course. Jamie McLaren playing second fiddle to Max Caputo. Never thought I'd say those words, but Caputo was terrific in the last start. And Matt Leckie coming back from a long-term injury. Great to see the Socceroo back, and I'm sure we'll see him on the park in the second half today.
You'd be forgiven for thinking, Zappers, that if you'd gone forward in time and seen that that was the bench today, we'll stay with Clay, because Melbourne City are on the hunt for an opening goal, and Leo Natel is shut down. And now Timmins has got his hands full with Natel, and the referee does bail him out with a foul. You'd be forgiven for thinking that Melbourne City had sealed the league and were so far ahead that they were putting all their big guns on the bench. Far from it, Grace. They are players that are having to earn their spot back, whether they're coming back from injury or just not in the best of form.
Well and truly far from it, but a formidable bench at that. Essentially City in a position that they're rather unfamiliar with, having to chase the top six, find their way into finals football. Still plenty of points up for grabs and available. They're looking to be included in their 10th consecutive final series, as Zappa's mentioned, off the top two. Incredible.
Subrayan here, the latest to get into a tangle. Big handful of Stamatolopoulos' jersey. If anything, helped break his fall. Both are back up, dusting themselves off. You can see there's a bit of a size difference between the two, but Stamatolopoulos' movement is what he'll be hoping to capitalise on, be evasive in that penalty area. Grozos here, with a bit of a mid-ranger to drop right at the edge of the box. All about the delivery then from Grozos. To the edge of the six-yard box he goes, and the looping up and under header proves no danger to the Melbourne City net. Himself tied up in knots. He's able to win a throw for his trouble. As he hurls down the line, Caputo got outbodied, and so Natta can sweep the ball back. Scott, as we've seen already, not afraid to come out of his penalty area when needed. Where goes Timmins? He hasn't got Stamatolopoulos ahead of the ball, though. Pass is intercepted. Flipped back. Ugarkovic, counter on counter. Might be to Melbourne City's liking. Yakalish against Woolmering one-on-one. Still Yakalish. Crowd urges him to shoot. It takes a deflection, but not so much that it could sit up kindly for Caputo.
Well, he's looked lively, Yakalish, this opening passage. Just looking to link up play on that occasion, creating a bit of space for himself. Got a shot away. Just finding the legs of Natta, but certainly down that right-hand side for City. They look to move swiftly.
Well, speaking of players that were out of form and favour, Yakalish certainly fell into that category at times during the season. Shallow back pass here. Ugarkovic and Natta trying to clean it all up. Ugarkovic persists. And now Ingham can clear. Jets defence all back on their feet. You see Ugarkovic getting himself back on side. Header away by Chancha. Gresh. And as things slow down, I think the Jets can exhale, but a hair-raising moment for Mark Natter. And the defending's not done just yet. Talbot making space on the right. An incisive pass from Yakalish, asking just a little bit too much of his wing back.
I can breathe a sigh of relief, but they need to take a deep breath. A couple of moments here for Newcastle. This pass, Mark Natter gets it all wrong. He's got a lot of work to do to recover it well, and a couple of really hairy moments at the back between Mark Natter, Ryan Scott. They're just bringing a whole lot of pressure on themselves and stitching each other up in really difficult moments.
First yellow card of the game here for James Jego. I feel like it's been building to this moment, Grace. There's been quite a few fouls so far in the match.
Yeah, well, for an opening 20 minutes, definitely a physical encounter. Both teams getting stuck in. 18 days since City last played an A-League match, so just keen to get back out on the park and win their 1v1 battles.
Jego, fresh off that card, sweeping to the feet of Ingham. He's been driving forward for the Jets in this game and given them quite a bit of energy. We spoke about the absence of Moragas. Well, it's almost like they've flipped that onus onto the opposite side of the pitch. And another foul here. Nuno Reyes into the back of Reno Piscopo now. Jets go backwards, though, from the resulting free kick and are happy to possess at the centre of defence. Lanatel ignored the shouts of Vicente Fernandez and decides to go on a roaming run of his own. One on two, shows a clean pair of heels. And the low cross, defended behind for a corner.
That was a great run from Lattel. Great turn, E. Streams past line, streams past two. Ingham, no slouch himself. Kankar with the touch that sees it out for a corner. He's frustrated at himself.
Short corner. Territory conceded. Back to Jego. Arslan. Talbot waxing with Ugarkovic. Now the rangy ball. The header. Yakalish popping up on the left side of the penalty area. And for the second time in the game, it's a Melbourne City header. Easily dealt with by Ryan Scott.
Not just a Melbourne City header, but a free header. A few questions of Newcastle Jets' defence, just allowing that to happen. And for City, well, they'll be ruining those chances all the time in the world.
Ugarkovic sees a wall of Newcastle defence. And Natel saw him at top speed a moment ago. He's only got a limited number of metres to play with here at the edge of the box. Newcastle set deep in defence. Jego, and they can't find the right pass to unlock the Newcastle defence on this occasion.
You can see the idea there. He's trying to pick apart what is a fairly compact Newcastle Jets defence. They get lots of numbers behind the ball quickly. On occasion, just those little triangles from City. Not quite meeting the target.
Ball is just booted high in the air out of a scrap. Stamatolopoulos protected the drop. Still have two defenders to deal with immediately. Natel. Early ball this time, tried to force it beyond Wilmering, who takes possession and now takes the ball up to halfway. Yakalish harrying him every step of the way. And eventually concedes the free kick. There's a close-up look at how it was given away and Yakalish's subsequent reaction. Into the edge of the box, and now right at the edge of the penalty area, a free kick in a dangerous position. And Steins is protesting that he's been targeted for physicality throughout the first half an hour, but again, just a free kick, no card, but this time in a very dangerous position.
Yeah, exactly right. Right on the edge of the box there. Steins saw the contact coming. A very dangerous position. Good numbers can be sent in. Unsurprising to see Grosos standing over it, but as well as Daniel Wilmering as an option.
So Wilmering, a natural left footer, just planted the seed of doubt in the mind of Jamie Young. Grosos, we've already seen take a range of set pieces so far in the match, most of them from a lot further out than this though. Is this the first significant moment testing Jamie Young in goal? Wilmering is the preference, and a shot on target, albeit one very comfortably dealt with by the veteran.
We saw the idea there, saw exactly what Wilmering was trying to do. The end product wasn't quite right. On target, yes, but didn't have the purchase behind the shot that it needed.
Doesn't that tell a story? Melbourne City nearly 100 ahead on passes in the opposition half. And the through ball here, nearly trying to connect another one. Caputo just caught behind Natto, who will be feeling a lot better about his defending now after a couple of phases where he's had to protect the ball and or his keeper.
Good use of body there by Natta after what was a really tidy bit of play right through the middle from City.
Piscopo lunges out to the ball and got into a bit of an arm lock against Nuno Reyes. He went to ground, couldn't convince the referee. And in the blink of an eye, City are down at their penalty area. Yakalish swings it in and Natta has to head it behind.
This is a look. Just a little pull, tug of the shirt there. From Nuno Reyes, Piscopo went down expecting the whistle.
There's a shirt grab there, but is it enough to lose your feet? I guess that's the question.
No, I think that's the argument there. Piscopo just needing to show a little more strength on the ball, especially in those battles. You know you're going to have that contact come through.
Another short corner. Deflected cross from Arslan. Suprayan. Happy to watch it bounce out on the opposite side. You might notice Melbourne City are wearing black armbands today. We saw on the left shoulder of Samuel Suprayan. In memory of the pop of Blake Henderson, one of the Melbourne City club employees who's been around Melbourne City forever and a day. As the shot on target here is held onto by Ryan Scott. So no doubt that's had a an impact on all of the staff at Melbourne City, and our thoughts are with Blake Henderson and his family. Thirty goalless minutes, not for a lack of trying between the two teams. And Melbourne City's press is once again forcing missed touches, missed passes and mistakes, but Piscopo on this occasion is able to get a foul and a bit of relief.
Well, that one will be called up. I think you're right, Tao. It's really Newcastle Jets just inviting their own pressure, their own mistakes, creating a couple of opportunities for City. It's those moments that can be tidied up on for sure for Newcastle. Just to limit the errors, get the basics right, and then look to move forward.
Say the start-stop nature is just starting to grate a little bit with regards to the game building any sort of cohesion and momentum. The players aren't getting on each other's nerves just yet, but it has really interrupted the flow quite regularly. Melbourne City looking to get back in the groove right here. Fernandez. Line commanded the ball, and then another foul, an indiscriminate grab around the shoulders from Timmins, and it's now one yellow card apiece as he joins Diego in the referee's book.
Might too be just a little bit of blood to the face for Tolgay Arslan, just grabbing at his mouth after the challenge. And really this pass, just all too simple, splitting through Newcastle's shape. Arslan checking off the line and can so easily just come in and pick up that ball.
So Rob Stanton definitely protesting to the fourth official, Adam Bavka, but Callum Timmins will have to watch his step from this point forward. See 14 total fouls. Newcastle probably right to inquire as to why their second foul of the game gets a yellow card, but the incident itself, I don't think there can be too much open argument. As Naha clears away. Gugarkovic received the ball well. Now Arslan unable to weave around Chanchar, and through comes Grozos. Timmins has the ball nicked off his toes, but it will be a Newcastle throw. Seen a great deal of Tolgay Arslan on the ball in that true number 10 position in the space near the top of the penalty area. Hands on deck as soon as he was played in by Gugarkovic there. Now more wrestling going on between Suprayan and Stamatolopoulos. It was unmissable there. You could see his shirt number stretching across his back, but the referee decided they had enough of a grapple on each other for play to continue.
This is a shape here from Newcastle I'm talking about. A little flat in the middle, which when a City player just checks off or holds their run, pick up the ball really comfortably in the middle of the park. It's Piscopo and Stamatolopoulos leading the line. They sort of dictate when to go and which way to push City, but it's this second pass that Newcastle have got to get under control.
Jakovic right against the line, breaks central to find a bit of room. And then twists a pass through. And Arslan, he can't keep it glued to his feet. Ryan Scott came out to make it awkward. And the initial pass from Jakulic was delicious. But it did not have the finish to match.
It was, wasn't it? And we've seen a few moments now from City just starting to find that killer pass. Delightful ball through to the feet of Arslan, who couldn't quite bring it into his stride. But certainly City, you can sense, you can start to feel, they're getting their dial in. starting to play some really nice passes in the final third.
Piscopo. And Timmins. A little bit of afters. Referee gives advantage. Piscopo. Timmins. Ingham making width over on the right. Whips in an early ball and just pumped away from contesting for it was Stamatolopoulos. Munoresh holding his ground. Ball tails out for a goal kick.
This is a look, that ball from Yakalish. The touch from Arslan, you can see exactly what he was trying to do, but it just escaped him by half a yard. When they're on song, and then some of that football is really pretty to watch.
Tumbling out of the way here, though. Newcastle nearly off and running. Ball is cleared away. Rino Piscopo, don't give up on it yet. Some backspin means it will fall kindly for Ingham. He finds a path through. Piscopo back on task here, and he's not able to twist it back for Steins. Grozos. Steins leaps for the ball. It hits his shoulder. Falls kindly for Rogakovic, who can launch a counter-attack. Yakalish is a lone hand up top, waiting for support to arrive. It's there now in the form of Caputo. Yakalish puts his head down and burrows forward. But he's turned away from the box. Rogakovic following in. Rogakovic! Good slide challenge coming through at the last from Timmins. Well, he held on for an extra half second there, Stephen Rogakovic, rather than pull the trigger. He spent so many years at Newcastle. He has scored against them for the Wanderers in the past. Should he have scored here for City?
Yeah, had to get that shot away. Took one too many touches. After Yakalish had done so well. Munoresh is flirting with a yellow card here, I think. But Yakalish did really well on that last passage. Just to hold up play, wait for a little bit of City support. It came in the way of Yugarkovic. Just didn't have the final product.
Rob Stanton is going to shout himself hoarse with so many minutes of the first half to go. 13 fouls to 2. And it's safe to say that Newcastle, Grace, feel as though the yellow should have been reached for on a couple more occasions than the one we've seen for Jimmy Jago so far.
Yeah, I don't know how much of a voice Rob Stanton is going to have into the second half. It's been a lively, entertaining first 45 minutes, almost there. Lots of physical challenges.
So whose concentration will hold up at the end of what has been at times trench warfare and at times beautiful flowing football? Jago, and now Arslan. Samuel Subrayan. Resch finds Arslan. Now Jago. Sweeping out to the left. Fernandez. Pick his mark in the middle. It's been headed back only as far as Natel. And that one was always rising. Sends it high and out for a goal kick. And until 20 appearances this season now for the three goals.
He certainly got onto that one. And it does feel like it's building for City. The opening few chances were almost gifted to them from Newcastle Jets' mistakes. They started to create a little bit more themselves.
So Ralph Napoli and then Scott Jamieson there. The Brains Trust for today, discussing things. I don't think there'd be any shortage of confidence from these two. They wouldn't be nervous about taking on the job. Melbourne City have certainly played like a team that's been pretty seamless in its continuity. Piscopo stopped the ball and now can go and retrieve. Jets get the throw.
Certainly getting a lot of attention, isn't he, Piscopo? whether it's through physical challenges or just not being afforded much space on the ball. Makes sense as well, because at his best, Piscopo can be the player that unlocks a defence.
Lamatel really blowing up here and giving away the free kick.
Just a lunging challenge. I think he did get the ball, but in the process also got Daniel Steins. Not too happy about it, though.
Well, Newcastle have had a handful of free kicks from this sort of distance. Piscopo has now relieved Grozos of duty. Quite a tall team have defended all of these so far effectively enough. And even though Clayton Taylor got the first touch, there wasn't any more advancing of the ball. Wilmering with just a high, hopeful swing at the ball and very nearly fell awkwardly for Jamie Young. But fortunately for him and City, it went wide of the post. So, half-time team talk for Ralph Napoli, Scott Jamieson and Melbourne City, Grace. Do they ask for anything a great deal different? Is it simply a matter of persistence and then maybe they might have that team talk changed right here? Jakalic. Bugarkovic whips it in, headed away by Ingham. And Jego sent to the ground by Piscopo. Referee waves to play on. Garkovic again. Talbot. Over the head of Alden Sundry in the penalty area. Recycled back all the way into the defensive half. Look how high Jamie Young has come up, almost to the halfway line. And then Natel down in the corner. Fernandez. Suprayan. It's a long string of passes for Melbourne City. Does it end with a shot on goal? Tonga Auslan. Clever from Bugarkovic. Jakalic lays it back. Talbot. And if anything, a miss hit cross rather than a strike.
Well, after quite the build-up. See the reaction there from Talbot, just throwing his head back in frustration. He knows that final delivery pass needed to have more quality about it.
But yes, back to the question about the halftime talk, is it a case of more of the same? And if the starting 11 can't grind Newcastle down, then the personnel changes, McLaren, Leckie might be the answers to do so. Or do you think there is something different about the way they are tactically approaching the game that you'd like to see from the home side?
They haven't been without their chances, and as I said, whether that's been through a couple of errors from the Jets or created themselves. Six shots on target, really nothing that have troubled Ryan Scott all too much. So I think it's going to be about having that final quality, that pass, that finish, that shot, just needing a little bit more about it.
All the tricks coming out here from Tonga Auslan, and there is a foul at the end of it and a yellow card for Dane Ingham. And he knows it's a yellow. He goes and apologises for wiping out Tonga Auslan. But that was one, two, three times he wanted to dance on the ball and show his trickery. And ultimately, Dane Ingham went through him with a reducer.
Yeah, just late to that. Ingham reckless in the challenge. And Tonga Auslan, who was so good with the ball at his feet and just breaking through lines on the dribble. And well, if current approach isn't working for City. You've just mentioned the players they've got on the bench. There's so much quality. A lot of goals sitting on that Melbourne City bench, ready to come on.
Of course, Terry Antonis has been an amazing source of goals. Five of his own this season. McLaren with eight. Leckie, just the six appearances and one goal in what's been an injury hit campaign for him. But we all know what he's capable of. Fourth official Adam Bavka signals just the one additional minute to end the first half. So it would be quite the turnaround if Newcastle, after a string of free kicks in this sort of range, this sort of distance from the penalty area, ultimately to concede to really the first look of this kind that Melbourne City have had for themselves. Arslan drops it near the penalty spot. Reyes. Oh, and it's found a way through. Nuno Reyes, in first half stoppage time, puts City into the lead. And Newcastle will rue that they did not hold out till the break.
In the dying seconds of this first half, it felt as though it had been building for Melbourne City. And on the Harvey Norman replay, a delightfully dinked ball in from Tolga Arslan. How this got to the far post uncontested in Nuno Reyes. And Ryan Scott, he will be bitterly disappointed with this effort. He had eyes on it and just at the very last second lost the fly to the ball. But nonetheless, City have taken the lead into the sheds at halftime.
It took him 74 A-League games to score his first in City Blue. Now he's got two in two. And the international break certainly didn't interrupt his goal-scoring momentum. But as you can see there, Ryan Scott does not have the ball at the kickoff line. He's got it at the edge of his six-yard box. And I wonder if that means VAR is going to have a say. The ball now meanders its way up into the centre circle.
Well, the question mark for me will be at the point of delivery from here. Look at the run of Reyes. And has he just lent himself into an offside position at that line? If so, Ryan Scott handed a miracle, perhaps.
Oh. Offside's the call. And Ryan Scott, himself a junior cricketer, will be relieved that he wasn't bowled over by that little off break from Nuno Reyes off the outside of his right boot.
Well, when you see the line there, you can see at the far post or at the far run there, Nuno Reyes standing alone, is in an offside position. Disappointing for him. And a moment of relief for Newcastle Jets.
And so the game remains scoreless and Nuno Reyes' scoring streak is, well, it's still active at one. It hasn't extended to two, but he'll have the second half to do something about that. We've gone well beyond the additional minutes. How much left remains in this first half? Melbourne City, right as they thought they'd got reward for their first half of trying to wear Newcastle down. Suprayen is holding his left leg. Just caught on the inside there by Stamatolopoulos. Quite late with the contact. Just a foul given. Nothing more. And the halftime whistle goes. So goalless at Amy Park. Melbourne City thought they'd got the breakthrough. Nuno Reyes thought he'd scored two in two. Instead, VAR would intervene and find that he was offside. And it means that we wait for the opening goal. Relief for Ryan Scott in the Jets' net. And a half filled with fouls and some, well, simmering tensions. Maybe now Jason Hoffman here, one of the substitutes getting involved with Tolga Arslan, is just starting to heat things up. Players with cooler heads trying to usher each other down the tunnel because there's still 45 minutes of fun to go. Melbourne City nil, Newcastle Jets nil.
Next up, we've got Sydney FC taking on the Central Coast Mariners here at Allianz Stadium. Alex Brosk, two of the most exciting teams in the Isuzu Ute A-League going head-to-head. This feels like it could be a cracker.
It does.
It's a cracker.
And in terms of premiership hopes and indeed finals hopes, feels like there is plenty on the line here at Allianz Stadium tonight.
Now for Torpy, and this time it's Caitlin Torpy's goal. Gorrie, oh, that's a lovely little touch, and that's goal number six. Driven back in, and there it is. Her fourth. Rasso winds up, and Rasso scores. There it is for Saya, and she's got it this time. At last, she says.
Thank you, Zappers. Well, it's a game as we go to the Harvey Norman highlights, Grace, that nearly gave us the goal that perhaps it needs. And Newcastle early doors. Ryan Scott came out of his area, but Togo Arslan wasn't able to punish him. And it just started a gradual build-up of chances throughout the half for the home side.
Yeah, it certainly felt as though City were building into it. A few defensive errors afforded City some opportunity that otherwise weren't there. Newcastle just giving away some cheap possession at times. They did have a couple of opportunities of their own. But I'd say at either end, perhaps both sides just trying to be a little too cute with it. Needed to put their boot through the ball on occasion and really test out either goalkeeper at either end.
See here, Max Caputo had that header on target. Would be one of two free headers, ultimately, that City would have on goal in the game. But neither of them could actually move Ryan Scott off his line.
Yeah, well, you see those two back-to-back, almost carbon copies. Time on the ball to redirect, and this is the chance, or the finish indeed, that was ultimately ruled offside. A really poor error there from Ryan Scott, and he knows that as well, but was handed a bit of a lifeline on that occasion.
And so that offside call came in first half stoppage time. VAR Chris Griffiths-Jones with a quick ruling in order to leave this game at 0-0. But what do the numbers say, Grace? Other than the scoreline, the XG is not huge from six shots on target for Melbourne City. That passes in opposition half. It is starting to get a little bit more balanced because City were 100 in front at one point.
Yeah, for sure. But City definitely momentum leaning in their favour. A lot of the action happening in their attacking half, final third entries, and as well a really physical match we're seeing from both sides.
So most of the action going on down at Newcastle's defensive end, and Ryan Scott, Melbourne raised, has been the man at the centre of attention. Of course, he was on the books of Western United for three seasons before getting his shot as the number one at the Jets, but he's had some hair-raising moments on his return to his hometown today.
Look, hasn't been Ryan Scott's best performance this afternoon by any means, but he'll be the first to put his hand up and acknowledge that. Definitely the busier of the two goalkeepers.
And he leads the Paramount Plus Player Index at half-time, perhaps because of a bit of fortune that that goal was chalked off. But, Grace, no surprise that it is four other Melbourne City players who are top of the leaderboard. We will revisit the Paramount Plus Player Index as we go through the afternoon. Let's throw it back down to Michael Zappone pitchside, who has a very special guest for us.
Next up, we've got Sydney FC taking on the Central Coast Mariners here at Allianz Stadium. Alex Brosk, two of the most exciting teams in the Isuzu Ute A-League going head-to-head. This feels like it could be a cracker.
It does, and a couple of weeks in the making as well after the international break. It's a cracker fixture to get us going for the week. And look, two sides, like you said, that love to score goals, have the most in the competition, and it does make for, I guess, a very entertaining match.
Two key components of that are Josh Nisbet and Anthony Caceres. Josh Nisbet made his Socceroos debut during the week. How much of an impact will they have on the result here today?
Look, Nisbet's a fantastic player. He's the heart and soul of that team. He gets them going from the back into midfield and into good areas. He's a tricky little player. And Anthony Caceres for Sydney, the exact same. You know, he's the guy who gets them going, has that little bit of quality that, you know, that can produce and provide to the likes of Joe Lolly and Fabio Gomez up front. So two exciting players, two great players, two great attacking teams, and hopefully we'll see a lot of it tonight.
And in terms of both premiership hopes and indeed finals hopes, feels like there is plenty on the line here at Allianz Stadium tonight.
Change of angle and heading in! What a beauty for Sydney FC! And it's the skipper on the night!
Shifts it in to Nisbet. Josh Nisbet has done it again!
Here's Courtney Perkins with time and space, and Jordan Courtney Perkins!
Docker again. Torres on that left foot. Oh, brilliant finish!
it was hot at the end of the first half. Philip Cancar not happy with referee Daniel Cook. Has an acrimonious end to the first 45, sets the table for the second here at Amy Park. Scoreless at the break, and for the Newcastle Jets, who last beat Melbourne City at this venue in October 2015, they must feel as though they have a foothold in the game, even though Melbourne City have shaded it to this point so far. Jamie Young certainly less tested than his opposite number, Ryan Scott. Melbourne City to attack the left of your screens, kicking off here in the second half. They need to win to jump back into the top six of the Isuzu Ute A-League Men's. And as former Matilda Grace Gill rejoins me here, Grace, we spoke at length about when Melbourne City might turn to the bench in this game, but Newcastle, they have an array of attacking weapons and speedsters of their own, as Leo Natel is able to win a corner from the very first phase of play.
Well, it looks as though this second half is starting exactly as the first finished. Physical, neither side holding back. I imagine we'll see a little bit of the same for the next while until both sides turn to the bench, invariably around about that 60-minute mark.
Out swinging corner and over the bar from Samuel Suprayen. A little bit like Nuno Reyes, is just starting to get an eye for goal, Suprayen. Led Mark Natter to the ball, and he got up for the improvised volley, but couldn't keep it down.
Yeah, good connection on that. Couldn't quite redirect it, but nonetheless a good target.
Team lists appearing on your screen. You'll see a handful of yellow cards so far in the game. And tensions really built to a crescendo at the end of that first half. Rob Stanton has been really working the fourth official, Adam Bavka. Certainly the Jets, with a fairly lopsided foul count, feel as though Melbourne City should have had a few more of their players in the book. Of course, they have had two end up with yellow cards. This man here, Timmins, and also Dane Ingham, who's currently standing at right back. This is Mark Natter, plays the ball to Daniel Wilmering. Tries to bend a pass around to Stamatolopoulos, and he's got the better of his marker. And then a good recovery challenge coming from Nuno Reyes. To go to ground to get the ball away, but he did so and executed it well.
He's done really well to recover there, the challenge, Nuno Reyes. Nothing but respect between these two players. That's a very well-timed challenge.
Jimmy Jago, the Melbourne City player, who picked up a yellow card in that first half. See Jamie Young redirect play out to the right flank. Callum Talbot certainly picked his moments when to get forward, but he's been given a bit of physicality from Clayton Taylor here. Taylor slips the ball down the wing. Wilmering getting forward, the left back. We know he's not unfamiliar with this position as Timmins blazes away, blocked immediately. Rino Piscopo now shooting straight into the ankles of Suprayen. Jets, couple of ambitious attempts at a long shot, neither of them beating the nearest defender, and Melbourne City can repel. Arslan, an inverted outside of the foot pass, very clever, finding its way over to the right side of attack, and now he follows up again, and the intercept is made by Grozos. The game is stretched for the early stages of the second half. Stamatolopoulos with Piscopo making ground in the middle, and he finds him here, Rino Piscopo, and sent it back to Stamatolopoulos, who at full stretch couldn't get to the ball.
Well, what a moment for Newcastle. That opened up so nicely, end to end at the moment, transitional play.
Deflected cross from Clayton Taylor's allowed to bounce in the 6-yard box, and then Vicente Fernandez gets it away. Well, new questions being asked by this Newcastle attack. And Clayton Taylor, after having a very quiet first half, has clearly responded to the halftime team talk. Piscopo here, wrapped up in a one-on-two. And now Timmins crashing through again. He's got a shoot-on-site policy at the moment. Unfortunately, Piscopo remains down with a knock to his ankle. And Melbourne City will play 11 versus 10. Jakulic to Agarkovic. And Natter cools everything down. Clayton Taylor back helping out the defence. However, he can't get the ball out for a throw. Melbourne City take possession. Jago. You see Stamatolopoulos coming back, but still no Piscopo there. And now it's bombs away towards the sideline. And Reno Piscopo, you see the number 10 back on his feet. There's Ralph Napoli, the Melbourne City coach. Aurelio Vidmar unwell, unable to take the technical area today. So Ralph Napoli, who was part of Patrick Kisnorbo's staff over at Troyes in France, is in the dugout today. And 5 minutes into the second half, Grace, there's been a real new lease of life injected into the contest. And that star-studded Melbourne City bench filled with Socceroos like Leckie, McLaren and Good, they're all off to warm up.
Well, the second half has started in quite a flurry, hasn't it? Very transitional play from one end to the other. Newcastle with a chance that opened up really, really nicely, but still plenty happening.
Leonatel. A sliding cross and met by Yakalish. And he does have just the one A-League goal to his name this season, unable to double his tally.
Well, this is a really, really good quality cross. Not only to have the vision, but to hit that pass to Yakalish on the ground at pace. That is a wonderful cutback there from Natel.
Stamatolopoulos trying to outfox Nuno Reis, couldn't do so. Ball finds its way back to Jamie Young. 18 total shots in the game. The on-target count skewed very much Melbourne City's way. And the XG tally not quite ticking over the way either side might have liked to this point. Could change right here though. Caputo! Great save initially. Ugarkovic! And Ryan Scott celebrates as Ugarkovic sends it wide. Relief again for the Jets keeper. And the former Newcastle man, Ugarkovic, couldn't hit the target.
Well, it had to be a shot on target, at very least. If not in the back of the net, you don't get many more opportunities that fall as kindly as that. Did have a little bit of a bounce. And Ugarkovic, who has been very good in the opening half of this match, hands on the head. Knows he had to do better. Knows he had to force a save out of Ryan Scott.
Well, he's an irregular goal scorer. 15 in 215 A-League appearances, but he does have two this season. And if anything, goal scoring is something that has been steadily added to his game. But not on that occasion. Missing the target. Big, big chance for Melbourne City. And Caputo threw a very good save out of Ryan Scott. The young striker, he's not been overly prominent in the build-up play, but he did have the header in the first half, and then the volley which Scott was able to save here.
For sure. And Caputo found himself in a good amount of space to connect first time, which is good to see. And Ugarkovic, who I think has been, even at times, a little underrated across the course of this season. He's had his moments in this first half, in this game. Some really bright patches.
Fernandez and Stamatolopoulos, just a little brush on the side of the cheek. Not so much a clash of heads as a glancing blow. Rob Stanton continues to talk to his assistant coaches. Piscopo rolls away, fouled by Ugarkovic. Piscopo, who thought he was subject to unfair treatment in the first half, is quick to remind the referee that the fouls keep coming here in the second.
Yeah, and he certainly has been targeted, Piscopo. That challenge a little late. He's asking where the yellow card was, and perhaps a fair question too.
See the foul count, 15-3, skewed Melbourne City's way. Shot on the turn, Stamatolopoulos. Just Newcastle's second shot on target of the game, but he picked out the chest of Jamie Young.
It was a nice clean strike. Got it away. But equally up to task was Jamie Young. Hasn't had a huge amount to do so far in this game. But chances like that, he's alert to the danger.
Ljubakovic got through one block tackle. Timmins has to twist around and send the ball out. Return pass, misses the throw intake of it. Nuno Reyes pressed up and kept the attack going. Switch finds Leo Natel one-on-one against Ingham. Natel got to his right foot, but Ingham stuck to him and blocked the ball away. And he's playing the outlet pass here to Steins. Piscopo can't get past Jimmy Jago. Ingham. Piscopo. And a hefty slide challenge from Fernandez finds the safety of the line. Steins in a tangle one on two, but he does get the throw in. So as Rob Stanton prowls his technical area, Newcastle are deep in attack. Piscopo, did he catch an arm there from Jago? Referee remains unmoved, and the counter-attack might be on for Melbourne City. Talbot away down the right. Bending pass into the path of Yakalish. Now back to Talbot. Newcastle set behind the ball. Togai Aslan goes to work. Aslan saw the long shot. And he had the crowd fooled, but it dipped late. Not in time.
It's a tidy hit from Togai Aslan. You expect nothing less. Such a technician. See the drop on that ball. Perfect angle as well. You can't afford to give players of his quality that much time and space. Took a couple of touches, cut back onto his right foot, got a shot away.
Aslan has been a regular source of goals, assists, and if he hadn't been sent off after the full-time whistle against the Perth Glory and incurred a lengthy suspension, you suspect he'd be in the conversation for the Johnny Warren medal, but that, of course, rendered him ineligible for such a prize. And coming back from an offside position here was the man himself. Flag went up, and a few Newcastle players are pointing over to the assistant referee, Peter Jaworski. Play hasn't stopped. We're going to continue on. This will be a talking point of City score right here. Shouts for handball, half-hearted as they may be. And Newcastle clear their lines. Steins can pick his pass. Piscopo's his option. He'll turn right into trouble here. Perhaps didn't catch Leo Natel in the peripheral vision. Half-hearted shouts for handball, Grace. Not much to them. A little bit to them.
Well, a little bit to them. The outstretched arm of Kankar there. They're definitely having a look at it.
We saw Peter Jaworski, the assistant referee, raise his flag in the build-up. This was the same phase of play.
Well, it was interesting because the flag definitely went up. Newcastle Jets players suggesting that Togai Aslan had returned from an offside position.
There is Peter Jaworski over on the outer side. What is in the purview of VAR? I'm almost certain, unless I've missed a rule change, that if it was offside in the build-up, then the handball might be fruit of the poison tree. Not to get into too much legal jargon here, Grace.
No, that would be my understanding as well. If there was an offside, then...
And I think common sense might have prevailed. So it did look like a handball, and perhaps that's why the fans are booing, but they may not have seen that it was potentially offside in the build-up. So the game remains goalless, And at the hour mark, both sides are poised to start making substitutions en masse to try and find a catalyst for the opening goal. Jego didn't like any of his options ahead of the ball, sends it square. Nunaresh, switch of flanks. Mattel found his feet after a little slip upon bringing the ball down. Feeds the ball to Tolga Arslan. Can't find a cutback though. Good one-on-one defending. Energetically cleared away by Timmins. Arslan again, surrounded by three Newcastle opponents. Engages a fourth in the form of Piscopo. City have to concede a little bit of ground. Nattel in a tangle with Ingham. Steins was third man in, cleverly past Jego, but not Suprayan. And now Ugarkovic receives in space. Talbot bombing forward. Callum Talbot with a drive straight into the arms of Ryan Scott.
Well, why not really there from Callum Talbot? Space opened up really nicely in front. A positive first touch. He was a little more involved in the first 45 minutes. Talbot just looking to get himself back into the game this second half.
And as that pass slides errantly out, let's go down to ground level. Michael Zappone, what's the latest from the pitch level of the game?
Yeah, thanks, Teo. A couple of substitutions for Melbourne City. Ralph Napoli going to the bench for the first time. Newcastle preparing some changes as well. We'll see Jamie McLaren enter the fray. Jimmy Jego coming off. And Terry Antonis, of course, also coming onto the ground. Terry Antonis scoring that spectacular goal the last time they played here at Amy Park, which was against Western Sydney. That goal's going to take a lot of beating in the goal of the year competition. Antonis has been in good goal scoring form so far this campaign as well. The Newcastle Jets, one change for them as well. Taylor coming off for them, and Lachlan Bayless coming on. But interesting to see Jamie McLaren on the park. 8 goals for him so far this season. And you look at his goal-scoring record over the last few seasons, it's been a barren one in comparison. 24 last campaign, 16 before that, 25 the year before that, and 20 the year before that in 2019-2020. So still plenty of football to be played this season, but Jamie McLaren being left on the bench in the last couple of weeks, looking for a point to prove in the next half an hour, Taylor.
Thanks, Zappers, and certainly McLaren will be hoping the level of service that has come for the City attackers will continue to him. Ralph Napoli executes his first changes over on the bench. Lachlan Bayless is playing just his 7th A-League men's game. He's made 1 Australia Cup senior appearance as well, still yet to find the back of the net for his first A-League goal. So Rob Standen getting a little bit younger, a little bit less experienced, bringing on the 19-year-old. But wasn't quite Clayton Taylor's day over on that wing, was it, Grace? So Bayless now gets his chance to try and run at Callum Tuck.
Yeah, good opportunity for Lachlan Bayless. Just starting to increase his minutes after a really difficult long-term injury. Came off the bench last week as well. And you mentioned just his 7th appearance. So just starting to build back a little bit of fitness, but fantastic to see him back out on the field and a little more regularly at that.
Steins pressing all the way up to the keeper, Fernandez. Here's Terry Antonis. Immediately trying to make something happen. Nattel has his pass screened and cleared by Kankar. As far as Antonis, though, Arslan, referee right on the scene, had a bird's eye view. And now Grozos, he does get the whistle. And that will draw the ire of the home fans. Yellow card as well for Nunaresh.
We saw the reaction of Grozos there. Frustration's just bubbling over. Cynical foul in the middle.
apologies. The yellow's definitely for Antonis, not for Reyes. So Antonis has come off the bench. He's played one nice pass. And now he's got himself in the book. VAR. Yeah, mistaken identity. There we go. So the yellow card was shown to Reyes, and the referees had the quick word in the ear from Chris Griffiths-Jones, and he's just made 100% sure that Terry Antonis knows he's the man on a yellow card, and Nuno Reyes knows that he is not.
Well, Nuno Reyes was just on site, wrong place, wrong time, and handed the yellow card, but in fact Antonis, the correct recipient in that case, really slowed things down, the run of Grozas. He was away down the middle.
Here's Bayliss, a bit of energy off the bench from Lockie Bayliss. And the cross slides through. Piscopo, Steins! Great chance for the Jets. And he didn't find the strike he needed.
Well, what an introduction there from Bayliss. A brilliant ball across the six-yard box. Teed up ever so kindly. And Steins has to do better there. Has to get the shot on target.
Given away here by Scott Nattel. Crowd was urging him to shoot. Would have been offside. Flag is up.
Just speaks to the transitional nature of the game we're seeing before one replay is done. The ball's down the other end of the field and an opportunity on goal.
It doesn't have the feeling of game gets decided by the odd goal. It just feels as though one goal either way could really be the thing that sets it off for an exchange of haymakers before we're done.
And two, it hasn't been a game without its chances. We've just seen there in as many minutes really genuine opportunities, both teams just failing to find that final bit of quality.
Consistent attacking being done by both teams into the second half. Ingham with a burst of speed. He's got the City midfield beaten, just the defence to contend with. Piscopo. What about the long shot, then dragged it towards Bayliss, who perhaps wasn't expecting the pass. And now Ugarkovic takes on Grozos and is forced to double back.
He had Aslan inside as a pass. If he could just find it around the shoulder. It's ended up back with him anyway.
Antonis. Cross came in from Fernandez, but was dealt with by Wilmering. Suprayan. Nattel, underlapping run. Who's going to be honoured here for Fernandez? Scott, two-fisted punch away. Awkward bounce to deal with for Talbot. Now Grozos. Here's Yakalish. Ugarkovic saw something he liked but didn't get the elevation on the ball in. At the 70-minute mark, Grace, but the Melbourne City home fans, they are not getting impatient just yet. Certainly, at times, they are happy to slow the tempo right down, play the ball around their defenders, not force the issue, but the groans and the boo boys aren't creeping in just yet. They seem happy enough to be patient with this 0-0 scoreline.
As that time ticks away, sure, frustrations will start to settle in. As mentioned, certainly not a game without its chances at either end. Feels as though it does deserve a goal.
And the crowd rise here for Nattel taking on Ingham. Ingham went to ground. Textbook challenge. Ball goes behind for a corner. Nattel remains down. The crowd are trying to do the referee work for Daniel Cook here, but I don't think he's going to be swayed.
Well, I am really enjoying this battle between Leo Nattel and Dane Ingham. Ingham being called to task on a number of occasions. It's a well-timed challenge. Gets the foot to the ball. Ingham has not only been solid this afternoon, but he's also had a fantastic season despite a difficult Jets year.
You can see here, City with no incentive to hurry up. They want to make sure that Chris Griffiths-Jones in the VAR booth has had a fulsome look, but Ingham does take the entirety of the ball. Play remains held up here. Still, we wait for this decision to be ticked off. All sorted. Corner incoming. And so, after a bit of time to build the suspense, Arslan to the near post. Up and underheader from Yakalish. Suprayen. And then Timmins and Grozos combine to clear. Huge skew in the pass in opposition half count. Now 200 difference between the teams.
Ball number 37, foul.
And the foul is paid here in a wide area, but Melbourne City might be inclined to play it quickly. Does Tolga Arslan have a set piece that he prefers? Seems as though he's just going to wait and say, everyone get in the box, we're not going to play it quickly. Go and get the numbers in there and line up. And now he does play it quickly. Terry Antonis, we know he can score from distance. He clips it back. Tolga Arslan, and he's not able to bring the ball under his command.
Well, clever training ground move. The thumbs up from Antonis. And his opposing number 10 does enough just to put him off. Piscopo tracking the run well there of Arslan. You see exactly what they were trying to do. Two as City continue to press high right on the edge of the 18-yard box then. Only now Ryan Scott just pushes his players a little further up.
Fernandez. Natel resumes his duel against Ingham. And there's a little bit of afters here with Timmins. Timmins, who is on a yellow. Natel seems a bit susceptible to the wind-up, safe to say. And now he's leaned in here at Costa Grozos, and this just might set things off. Ryan Scott has come in, and the push and shove starts. And Natel, who started it, now wants to finish it and walks away. Rozos is still saying, what about the potential headbutt there? It didn't make contact. But the intent may yet draw the attention of the officials. Players have untangled themselves at least, but how much more will there be to the story?
Well, it's probably a little bit to unfold here. Tempers flaring from seemingly a bit of a nothing situation. And the moment there, it's still kicking on, but referees having a good look and just trying to get this situation under control.
Tough scene, and now this morass of players is within earshot of the Melbourne City bench, no doubt. The Newcastle sideline as well. So this is the next phase. It was Talbot coming in, and I don't think he's made contact with anyone there. Ryan Scott, he got into a grab and a grapple. Nertel was able to separate himself from that seemingly easily enough. The assistant referee here is Andrew Memorakis. He's having a word to Daniel Cook. I don't know, Grace, is there a red card offence in there or not? Hard to say.
Oh, there's a lot to unpack, and I think if there was contact in that leaning in on a headbutt, that would be what they're looking at. Other than that, it was just a little bit of a coming together, a yellow card it would be.
So Grozos gets a yellow card, Nertel gets a yellow card, and no one that previously had a card goes in the book. Newcastle will now make this double change. Youth and experience. Jason Hoffman on for Daniel Steins, and Archie Goodwin, who has that magic goal-scoring touch. Doesn't really matter how many minutes they give him, he always seems to find a way. He's going to come on, and Reno Piscopo is going to make way. So if ever the Archie Goodwin goal-scoring touch was needed for Newcastle, it's right here in a game that is poised 0-0. And they are trying to win against Melbourne City at Amy Park for the first time in 8.5 years.
Well, you said it there, Teo, youth and experience. Archie Goodwin, while it's his 18th appearance, he's played less than 500 minutes across the course of the season.
Okay, now we go to VAR.
Yeah, a bit to look at here, as I mentioned.
So, Leo Nertel and Costa Grozos, who had seemingly left the vicinity and were happy enough. Oh, maybe... See, does that angle show his contact? It's funny because Daniel Cook's right there. I mean, he's in literally the perfect position to make a decision, and did. So, are we going to see the decision overturned? Looks like it. He gave the TV signal, but not to call back one of his cards. Trying to get to the bottom of that. In the meantime, Melbourne City have a change. Leo Nertel perhaps wisely subbed out of the game. Matthew Leckie gets to reload another comeback again. He looked so good earlier in the season when he came back and scored, but injury has followed him like a curse this season. It cost him a spot in the Socceroos at the Asian Cup. Perhaps now a more sustained run will be possible.
Great to see Matt Leckie back out on the field and recovered from illness as well in the last fixture.
Here's Goodwin's first involvement. A bit of head tennis and then cleared away by Supraya. Feels like we're going to have a fair bit of stoppage time as a result of the VAR check. And so the subs off the back of it. Hoffman, first involvement's a flick header. Well, Callum Timmins is down off the ball. Hopefully just a cramp and not worse. Newcastle put the ball out because they're aware that, yeah, hopefully for his sake, just a cramp. I think that gives it away that it's just a cramp. In the meantime, Michael Zapponi, you had a bird's eye view of all the hullabaloo. Let's cross down to you.
Yeah, absolutely. Good officiating, I reckon, by Daniel Cook there. He obviously wanted to review the decision in the VAR, Chris Griffiths-Jones, and I could overhear the conversation, and Daniel Cook reviewed that footage and said he was happy with the yellow card and no need to upgrade it.
Thank you, Zappers. And there is Leo Nertel, who has since left the game. Stainingham might see that as a victory of sorts in their one-on-one duel that had occupied the two of them for 74 minutes. Is it cramp in both legs here for Timmins? Grace, just how difficult will this be to run off?
Well, when it looks to be at the point that Timmins is at, pretty difficult to return from. He hasn't played full games across the course of the entire season, Callum Timmins.
And his numbers up as a result. Brandon O'Neill is going to come on. So, if nothing else, it is another Jets player who was carrying a yellow card who makes way for a player with a clean record in O'Neill. And Timmins, who has quite literally run himself into the ground, is congratulated on 79 minutes of hard work.
The experience now of Brandon O'Neill just to come on, try and settle things. 10 minutes to play of regulation time. I think you're right, Tao. There will be a fair bit of stoppage time added onto this one.
And it still feels like a goal is on the way. It's just a question of which end. Melbourne City hope it's theirs. Top six spot tonight on the line. Lecky cuts it back. Fernandez. Antonis hangs across high, and the header of Wilmering keeps it away from Jamie McLaren, who was lurking out the back.
Well, they haven't been able to capitalise on corners or set pieces so far this game, City, but it has been a pretty happy hunting ground off corners across the course of the season for them.
As you can see there, the Jets haven't had a single one for the game. Talbot blocked by Goodwin, pressing from the front. Archie Goodwin, can the cavalry get forward in support? Wilmering's making a dashing run, so's Bayless. City have now got numbers back, and they've almost got a full defensive position, and so the red alert stops blinking and Newcastle can consolidate possession. O'Neill twisting across, headed away up by Grozos. Now Fernandez.
Yeah. Is it up there?
So just for a second there, it looked as though Archie Goodwin might have caught the City defence cold, but they got back in position very quickly and were able to stop any supporting runners from continuing the quick counter-attack. Hoffman here uses his strength. Stamatolopoulos. Bayless got first contact, but it wasn't goal bound. And now he's able to pick the pocket of Yakalish. Wilmering with a shot, saved by Young. Good strong hand to turn it out for a corner kick.
That's a wicked strike from Wilmering. Came off his boot really sweetly. Strong hand had to be from Jamie Young just to steer that around the goal, but hands on the head from Wilmering. What a strike.
Got to say, that's excellent goalkeeping technique from Jamie Young. I think he was well aware that he didn't want to parry it back into the oncoming path of any Newcastle attackers, so he just opened up his wrist and deflected it out for the corner. A lot has to go right to make sure you don't simply let it flap through your hand into the net or deflect it into your own goal behind you, but he did really well. And now the subsequent corner kick. First of the game for the Jets. It's taken until the 83rd minute. Grozos' corner. Met by a tumbling volley. Stamatolopoulos didn't generate much power. Now the counter-attack. Arslan out into space. Yakalish is running. Ingham's got the angle covered. Dane Ingham's really set himself for today's game. Ever-present for the Jets this season. And he's showing that match hardness today.
Late into this one continues to be such a transitional game. From one attack at one end down to the other. Dane Ingham full of running as well for Newcastle.
Well, they've got this far, the 84th minute. Can they get themselves a little bit more? So much talk in the international break about the future of the Newcastle Jets, the ownership situation, the uncertainty around what might come in the future. But the 11 players and the substitutes out there today have shown great character, something that would make their fans and the city of Newcastle proud. They'll be even more proud, and I would suggest delighted, if they can go on and grab the win here. There's no thoughts of throwing in the towel. This team is taking it up to Melbourne City here today. Goodwin and Ingham combine. Ingham trying to free the feet. Fernandez stuck to him. Hoffman, and now Grosos. The Jets concede 20 metres. Kankar, an ambitious pass through the gap. And the ball will be kept in by Hoffman. He refused to give up on it. Swings in the cross. And Archie Goodwin couldn't quite make ground. Jamie Young plucked it.
Perhaps an opportunity gone begging there for Newcastle. Stamatolopoulos, a target as well in the box.
Advantage given for the late shove. Cut back here. And Antonis, well, he's had some really good strikes from outside the box this season. Not just the halfway goal, do you think of the Adelaide home game as well? Grace, this was the chance just before for Hoffman, who didn't give up on the ball, and then Antonis skied it here.
So late in this game, 85 minutes in, from one end to the other, crosses in, either angle. Hoffman, he knows he should have pulled that cross a little further away from Jamie Young.
Paramount Plus Player Index. Ryan Scott was top at halftime. He remains top now. City left back Vicente Fernandez second on the list. We will revisit the Paramount Plus Player Index as part of the post-game show. Here is Fernandez, and he's dispossessed by O'Neill. Time starting to become the enemy of both teams, but we suspect there'll be a healthy, if not extended chunk of stoppage time at the end of this one. Definitely enough time for either team to win it. Fernandez. Cleared by Kankar, high up and under. Reyes lent into the header. Lecky, great control of the ball. And then the vision to see Yaklish on the right. Natter's header away. Reyes tried to thread the eye of the needle, and he may have done so. McLaren couldn't make contact with the cross. It flashes through the penalty area without a touch.
It was almost a comedy of errors there. Miscommunication between Jets players, flashing past the face of goal. Jamie McLaren with a little wry smile.
Ralph Napoli coaching in the interim today with Aurelio Vidmar unavailable. He is now riding every kick of the ball. He knows how important a win is this afternoon. Jets ball at the throw. Ingham goes for distance. Hoffman has come on to provide an aerial presence. City trying to move through midfield. Referee takes evasive action. Aslan finds Lecky. Nuno Reyes. He's got options on the right. Yaklish tucks it in for Talbot. Talbot lifts it across. Natter read it best in the air. Suprayan. Lecky slipped as he played the ball, but it didn't affect the destination. Fernandez hangs it up. Scott went for the punch in the end. And now sliced away by Stamatolopoulos. It's going to have a bit of backspin too. And that suits Yaklish. He protects the ball. Still Marin Yaklish. And he squares it up. Aslan. McLaren, Fernandez. Newcastle have packed the defensive penalty area. Suprayan. Now Antonis turns onto his right side, and it's over the leaping Lecky. We know he's a good aerial presence for his height, but that one was even too high for him.
A sustained pressure from City, just trying to pick apart the compact Newcastle Jets defence. The ball in from Antonis evades all. But it felt like City were building there. And much to Newcastle Jets' credit, just having to absorb pressure.
Well, it's a credit to Newcastle that it's taken until the 89th minute for them to be pinned, clinging on to this nil-all scoreline. You thought it might have come a little bit earlier, but it shows the balance we've had in open play. And that was really the first time Newcastle had all hands on the pump, trying to hold on. And we're about to find out how much stoppage time is left in this game. Yakalish, Talbot. It's a cross that brings groans from the crowd, but it still needed to be played at the far post, and it still wins a corner off Dane Ingham.
It's an awkward one to deal with as well, both for Ingham and for McLaren. Up and under.
Six additional minutes. It's a long time to be pinned to your goal line and holding on. That's what Melbourne City want to do to the Jets here. One might just be enough. Aslan waves everyone into the penalty area and then delivers the corner right to the hotspot. Header away by Ingham. Antonis. Aslan again. Pondering that second time ball. Instead, Talbot on duty. Supraen sets himself. Lecky's there and saved away by Scott. The cutback, a scramble! And it's turned away, and Ryan Scott celebrates saving again. Melbourne City cannot believe it.
Well, Tolga Aslan is furious. But what a save from Ryan Scott. On the spot, not once. But this one, point blank. And in the moment where Tolga Aslan was lining up the strike, frustration at his own teammate.
Marin Yakalish came in and picked the pocket of his own teammate. And Tolga Aslan, his reaction shows just how much two more points would mean for Melbourne City as they try to fight their way up the table. Neutral Wanderers fans watching on, hoping that Newcastle can do them a big, big favour here and cling on. Can the Jets hit on the counter? They've got the team out there to do it, but right now they're primarily focused on defence. Grozos. Ugarkovic. Lecky, he's made a difference since coming on. And the youngster Bayless stops his progress. Forces Melbourne City to go back and sideways, and two of six additional minutes have ticked by. Reyes right up the middle. Scott goes and catches.
Well, it's been a quality game by Nuno Reyes, but that pass, a little impatient, a little hapless. Gratefully into the hands of Ryan Scott, who is still amped from that save just moments earlier.
Kankar slides for the tackle, and now down the line, Hoffman, a flick header, a really good flick header. Goodwin, big handful of shirt, free kick Newcastle. And Jason Hoffman, coming on almost as a wide target man here, has been the get-out-of-jail pass on a couple of occasions. And his height and his aerial presence has been able to keep Newcastle in midfield or even attacking territory. And now he might be the obvious target here at this free kick.
Well, all his experience, Jason Hoffman.
Is this Newcastle's moment? Halfway through stoppage time. Grozos to take the free kick. Melbourne City will be setting themselves for the counter-attack if they can clear. And clear they do. Aslan away. Grozos short-circuits the counter initially. Or does he? It runs on for McLaren, but Scott's out of his area. Well, City got their look at a full-field counter-attack there, but they just couldn't execute. We've got multi-ball going. Supraen. That ball is live. Fourth official's going to retrieve the other one. Here's Talbot. Yakalish. Nuno Reyes. Can they find the right pass, Melbourne City? So many Jets defenders to play through here. Lecky. Talbot, not tempted by a long shot. Yakalish again, cuts it back, and it was read by O'Neill. and he just kicks for territory. It's barely a couple of seconds of relief. Tolgay Arslan. It's going to feel like a long 90 seconds for Newcastle. Jakalic leaves it with Talbot. Whipped in by Talbot. It bounces on for Lecky. He drives it low and Grozos gets the clearance away. Home fans urging Melbourne City on. They load up and go again. Lecky clips it into the box. Arslan, where's the cutback for him? It's not on. And he waits and he waits and bides his time. And now Lecky lifts it up. McLaren's there and tipped away by Scott again. Out for a corner kick, but Ryan Scott has had the answers.
Well, spectacular once again from Ryan Scott. Palming that over the crossbar. Tensions rising, nerves rising, 1 minute indicated remaining, even less than.
Tolgay Arslan puts a kiss on the ball. Rob Standen watches on. It's out of his hands now, it's up to his team. Can they hold on for what would be a point that would mean so much more of a statement about Newcastle, the club, than the season that we're currently in? For City, it's all about the now. They need a goal now. Here comes the corner from Arslan, headed away by Stamatolopoulos. And Archie Goodwin takes it and runs. Will that be time up for City? The slide challenge from Antonis keeps them in it. And cleared away by Wilmering. 6 minutes is up. Whistle in the mouth. It's a heroic hard-earned point for the Jets. And for Melbourne City, agony at 2 points dropped. Newcastle and City players collapsed to the turf. They ran themselves into the ground. But Newcastle can be oh so proud of the fight and the character that they showed here. What a statement about what their club stands for in such adversity. And for Melbourne City, the chance to jump into the top six is spurned. And those further up the table will be thanking Newcastle for fighting to the finish line the way they did. Melbourne City nil, Newcastle Jets nil. Grace Gill, a tough game to give your Alex Tobin 3-2-1. Who are your standouts today?
Well, there's a number of players who I thought had pretty exceptional performances in a game that didn't produce any goals. City probably could have won it in the end, definitely could have won it in the end, and perhaps how they didn't is still a question that will be asked. Nuno Reis, I thought, was excellent at the back for City. Steadfast in his defensive efforts, and as well Daneham. It was a game of transition, and those two defenders called into action time and time again. Steven Ugarkovic as well with the 1 point, very lively in the middle of the park for Melbourne City.
So those are the Alex Tobin points. Let's go down to the aftermath. Michael Cipone, take it away. to Michael Zapponi there. And as we look at some of the highlights of our Isuzu Ute player of the match, Grace Gill, it was a tough day to choose one, but Nuno Reyes, his defending is what stood out to you.
Yeah, it did. I think this opportunity aside, when he was called into action time and time again, Nuno Reyes was alert to the danger. He cut out a lot of opportunities for Newcastle, and although he thought he had found the back of the net on just his second occasion, it wasn't to be. A number of influential tackles, interceptions, blocks as well, led from the back really in a game that demanded a lot of defensive work, and he was at the centre of all of that.
And we can see there Togo Aslan and Ralph Napoli deep in discussion. Perhaps some instruction there about how they dealt with the frustration of not being able to convert their chances there. As we got into stoppage time, and it became a particularly desperate and stretched game. All right, let's go back down for some more reaction. Michael Zapponi. Thank you again to Michael Zapponi there with Ralph Napoli. Well, what about the action we had in this one? We're going to come back and wrap it all on the other side of this short break. Stay with us. It's the Isuzu Ute A-League Men's.